Hey guys, this is Austin Scott, Beck's field agronomist down in Kentucky, Tennessee, the Boot Hill of Missouri. I'm coming to you from South Middle Tennessee today to talk about a problem I've been seeing quite a bit here lately, and that's slug damage. As you can see, I just pulled some of this residue back and found a nice big slug right here. We've got some slug egg masses right here in this stover. As you can see from the tip of my knife blade there. Just wanted to put out a quick update on these slugs. Our common insecticides are not active. They don't really work on these slugs. The best thing for management on these little pests is good sunny days and dry weather. You know, a lot of situations that we're getting into right now, we're having to replant because the slugs actually eat the soybean as it comes up. They'll get on that hypocotyl and eat the hypocotyl. As you can see right here on this soybean plant, you can see the cotyledons are etched out pretty bad. There's some holes in them. That's where the slugs have actually got in there and eaten the cotyledons as they were starting to come up. But a lot of times they'll eat this portion right here. This is your hypocotyl. They'll eat it in half, or they'll eat it about 3/4 of the way. And then as that soybean plant emerges, it'll break the neck. So once that growing point's dead, that actual soybean plant is dead. So it's not going to be viable anymore after that. The best management strategies on these slugs, there are some slug baits out there, but they don't really provide much control of the slugs. And they're very expensive, $15 to $20 per acre. They're pelletized, and you spread them kind of like fertilize. But again, they're very expensive, and you don't get very good control with them. So the best management strategy to me is to come in here, if it's a full replant situation, is to actually work the field up. So put a disc in the field, put a turbo chopper in the field, get rid of some of this residue, and get these fields dried out some before you come back and spot plant in. If you are just gonna supplement the field with some population, if you're running 60,000 soybeans, you wanna be upwards of that 100,000 mark, you want to come back in, drop in at an angle, and don't plant the soybeans very deep. We want to shallow them up, running about 3/4 of an inch so that the beans actually get out of the ground very quick and outgrow the slug damage. Usually when you get to this stage right here, you get that unifoliate coming out. You've outgrown the slug by that point. You've got other growing points that even if the slug was to come in and eat the top of it out, the other growing points would kind of take over and branch out at that point. So if you can get to this stage, then you're usually pretty good. I just wanted to give you a quick update on this. It's what I'm seeing pretty much across my entire territory right now though. If you have any questions or any other fields that you need somebody to come look at, contact your local Beck's representative. We'll come out and take a look at the field and see if slugs are actually your problem or if you're dealing with other things. This is Austin Scott. Have a good day.